The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text number 23, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on April 11th, 1974, in Bombay, India.
Translation: the work of a man who is unattached to the modes of materialism and who is fully situated in transcendental knowledge merges entirely into transcendence.
Gatasanga samuttasya jnanavasthita cetasah jagyaya acharata karma samagram pravidiyate. The difficulty in the conditioned state that we are creating our next life by karma. We are just at the present moment we are acting according to our past karma, and again we are creating another karma so that we have to enjoy or suffer in the next life. The transmigration of the soul takes place according to karma. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Karanam gunasanga asya sadasat janma jonishu sat asat, good and inferior janma. So one has taken his birth in a nice family or in nice nation, good education, good looking, nice opulence, janma isajya sutasri. Janma means to take birth in good family, good nation, and isajya, opulence, very rich. Janma isajya suta, suta means knowledge, education, and sri, and beauty. I repeatedly say to the American people that you have got your this position, richest nation in the world, janma. Practically in America there is no poor man that I have seen. They do not know what is poor man, because the poorest man gets 5,000 rupees per month. The poorest man. So, actually there is no poor man. There cannot be. The government arrangement is so nice that nobody is in want of money. He can get money in so many ways. So it is very good, fortunate position to take birth in America. Janma. Rich family, rich nation. And aishadya, janma aishadya suta, education. Now they are advanced education, the scientific advancement, they are trying to go to the moon planet. Not only that, many machines up to date, they are discovered, using. There is very big company, IBM. Business machine, IBM. International business machine. You know everything. So, janma isajya suta, education, and sri. Most American boys and girls, they are all beautiful. So, why this position? This position is due to punna, karma. Karma means papa and papa karma, punna karma. This is the karmana daivanetrena jantar deha upapatti. This is said in the Srimad Bhagavatam. By karma, the janta, the living entity, jantu, he is getting a particular type of body. In Bhagavad Gita also it is stated that karanam gunasangas, pragitekyamanani gunai karmanisa. Karanam gunasangas, sadasat janma jonis. We are associating with a particular type of modes of nature. Goodness, passion and ignorance are mixed. So on account of this, we are working differently and we are preparing our next life. Karana. This is the karana. So, those who are karmakandiya, they are interested next life in the heavenly planet or higher standard of life. So, that is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Urdhanga chanti sattasva. If you associate with the modes of goodness, then you are promoted to the higher planetary system, beyond heavenly planets. Janalok, tapalok, mahalok, sattalok, siddhalok, brahmalok. So, that is possible. But our problem is not to promote ourselves to go to the heavenly planet or higher than that, Janalok, Sattalok, Mahalok or Brahmalok. Krishna advises, Abrahma Bhuvana Lokan Punaravartino. He does not encourage that he go to the Brahmalok. No. He never encourages. He says, Abrahma Bhuvana Lokan Punaravartino. Even if you become promoted to the Brahmalok, then again, you have to come back. Kine punne puno matra lokam visanti. As soon as your punna, the duration of life, is finished, then you have to come back again. This is going on. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, ei rupe brahmanda bhramite kono bhagavan jeev. We are rotating, wandering, in different species of life, different planets, different forms. In this way, we are transmigrating from one position to another position. This is going on. So, but that is not a very nice business. Bhutta bhutta praliyate. We accept some type of body or some time place. Suppose one has become American. Then how long he remained American? Say for 50 years or at most 100 years. Then again next chapter. One does not know what is the next life. And that will be decided. Karanam guna sangasya sadasajjanma janishu. There is no guarantee that the next life again you become American or Indian or Brahmin. You may become a cat and dog, because that is not in your hand. That is in the hand of material nature. Prakite kiramanani gunai karmani sarva. Karma. Karma na daivanetre. That will be awarded to you by superior judgment, that this man has done like this, he should get the body like this. That is not in your hand. That is not in your science. The real science is how to stop this business. That is being advised in Bhagavad Gita. Janma mitru jarabhyadi dukkha dosana darsana. Tapta deham punar jana. People do not understand this. That our real problem is not to become promoted to the higher position, but to stop this birth, death, old age and disease. That is the real problem. So Krishna said that gata sangasya, don't say like that. Gata sangasya, because we are getting different types of body in different planets and different spheres of life on account of our association to the modes of nature. Therefore, Krishna is advising gata sangas. Don't associate with the modes of material nature. That is your business. Not that you associate with the higher mode subtleness, even very good man, goodness, Brahman, that is also conditioned life. To become Brahmana, Satya Sama Dhamma Titikha Arjava Jnanam Vijnanam Astrikam Brahma Karma Svabhas, very perfect way of life. But that is also risky. Not that, everything is risky, because at any moment we can be associated with another quality. And karanam guna sangas, it is very difficult for it, mixture. Therefore Krishna advises that you become free from association of any of the modes of material nature. Any one of them. Gata sangasya, muktasya. As soon as you become free from the association of the modes of material nature, then you are mukta. Muktasya. Gata sangasya muktasya. And how mukti can be achieved? Muktasya. How this position can be? Na jnanavasthita cetasa. If you are actually situated in knowledge, then you can be mukta. Without knowledge, ignorance, just like a man in knowledge, he never commits any mistake lawfully. So he is not a member or subjected to be punished in the prison house, because he has got full knowledge of the law. If anyone knows, in ordinary dealing, just like keep to the right, keep to the left. If you are driving your car, if you are fully aware that if I go to the right, it will be criminal, then you are not subjected to be fined, mukta, if you are in full knowledge. Therefore, our first business is to be situated in knowledge. Jnanavasthita cetasa. So, this knowledge is being imparted by Krishna himself, Bhagavad Gita. The beginning of this knowledge is when Arjuna accepted him as Guru, Sishasteham, Sadhimam, Prapannam. Now no more friendly talks. I become your disciple. So, this is the position. Knowledge should be taken from the perfect person. Because if you take knowledge from a person who is defective, your knowledge has no value. You must take knowledge from the perfect. So anyone in this material world, he is defective. Every one of us will know that we are defective. What is that? We are very much proud of seeing. So what is the value of our seeing? We see under certain conditions, that's all. If there is immediately darkness, what is the value of our eyes? We cannot see. So under certain conditions, because we see, therefore you are not perfect. But if you can see in any condition, that is perfection. Not depending on these defective eyes or senses. That is not knowledge. Defective. Four defects. I have several times explained. One defect is that we commit mistake, everyone. And we become illusion, accepting something for something. That's like mostly, even educated person, they accept this body, and this body. Just like animals, the cats and dogs, they also think that I am this body. I have several times told you that he talked with Professor Kotovsky in Moscow. He said, after finishing this body, Samiji, everything seems. He said like, and he is a big professor. And according to our Vedic culture, jasyatu buddhi kunapi tidhatuke saiva gokhara. If one is going on under this impression that I am this body, he is gokhara. Ass and cow, an animal. Therefore, they do not know how we are accepting different bodies under karma. by associating with pleasure. Associating means even unknowingly. Just like infection. In medical science there is the word infection. You may not know, but if you have infected typhoid disease, it will rectify at one moment. So similarly, even if we do not know, if we associate with the material modes of nature, it will be affected. Sadasat janmajanishu. Therefore we must have full knowledge how to save ourselves from the association, from the infection of this material disease. That is called jnana-avastuti-cetu. Just like a man who knows hygienic rules and regulations, he does not infect disease. But a man in ignorance, he infects disease and suffers. It is not God's creation, your creation. If you do not know how to live, then you infect the infection of the different material modes of nature and you will have to suffer or injure. Therefore, common sense instruction given by Chanakya Pandit, the great politician, tajo durjana sansargam. This is his first mission. So don't associate with bad character. We are also doing that. But don't associate with the four principles of sinful life. Illicit sex, meat eating, intoxication, and gambling. Tajo virjana samsagam, bhaja sadhu samagam. You associate with sadhus. Who are sadhus? That is also described in the Bhagavad Gita. Sadhureva samantabha. Sammak bhagasita hi sa. Who? Apite sudurachara bhajate mamananna bhak. Sadhureva sam. That is sadhu. Sadhu means who is fully engaged in the service of the Supreme Lord. He is sadhu. So in this way, we have to acquire knowledge. Jnanavasthita cetasa, full knowledge. Then we can avoid the association of the three modes of material nature. Gata-sangasya, muktasya. Then you become liberated, even in this life, if you are actually situated in knowledge. And how one can understand that this man is mukta. He is not associating with any material modes of nature. How? Jagyaya acharata karma. For jagya. Jagyaya. Jagya karma samudbhavam. Just like I was explaining. You have to perform jagya. Jagyaya. Only for jagya. Jagyate, another place, Krishna said, jagyate karma, anatra karma bandhama. If you do not act for jagya, then you will be entangled in the karma bandhama. This is the science. One has to be situated in full knowledge. In full knowledge, the beginning of knowledge is that one must understand that I am not this body. This is knowledge. And if one is working like cats and dogs, thinking himself, I am this body, he has no knowledge. They're just like animals, they are not expected to be in knowledge. A man is expected to be in knowledge, and he must know that I am not this body. Dehinasmin jatha dehi kumana jovanam jara tatha dehantara prapti. So, one has to know that I am not this body, but circumstantially and according to my association with modes of nature, I am transferring and transmigrating from this body to another body. So, therefore in the Vedic culture, the karmakandya, yajna is recommended, at least you get a better body. don't go to the lower body. Urdhanga chanti satta swa, better body in higher planetary system. That is karma kandya vichara. Therefore, yoga, yogaya asarata karma. Everything should be in here. Yogya sister sino santa, muchante sarva kimisari. The same thing, just like here, they are performing yoga, the sankirtan yoga. We are preparing food for Krishna, that is yoga. And when we eat the remnants of foodstuff, that is also yajna avasishta, remnants of foodstuff. Yajna sishta sino santa, asino. Asino means eating. After offering in the yajna, if you eat, yajna sishta sino santa, you become a santa, saintly person. Yajna sishta sino muchante sarvakirmise. He becomes free from all sinful reactions. Abhunyante te avama papam je pachanti atmakarana. And he is cooking for himself very palatable dishes. He is bhunyante te avama papam. He is simply eating sins and he has to suffer. Therefore, we have to eat, we have to work, we have to do everything. Only for yajnaya, not for any other purpose. Then you are interned. As soon as we do anything for my sense gratification, then you are entangled. Goodness or bad, goodness, passion or ignorance. So there are very complicated laws that we do not know. That is ignorance. So we have to know what are these complicated laws. That is called jnanavastita cetasa. Ignorant person, they suffer from disease, they suffer from legal action because ignorant. Ignorance is no law, no excuse. If you go to the court, sir, I did not know this law. I did not know law that keep to the left. So, the court will not excuse you. I did not know that you associate with the smallpox infection. The nature will not excuse you. A child touches fire. The fire will not excuse. That because it is child, I shall not burn it. No, nature must work. Devi jesa gunamai mama maya durataya. So, you have to be fully in knowledge. How to save yourself from the contamination of the modes of material nature. That is called gata sangasya, muktasya, when you are free. So that is also stated. How you can become gata sangasya? That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Mancha vyavicharini bhakti yogena jasevate sagunan samatita ita brahma bhuyaya kalpate. You have to situate yourself on the Brahma platform, the spiritual platform, mancha abhyasin. How you can do it? Na abhyavicharini bhakti yogena. Bhakti yoga. You have to perform bhakti yoga. Then what is that bhakti yoga? Saranam kirtanam Vishnu, smaranam padasevanam, archanam bandhanam dasam, sakham mātmani. These are the bhakti yoga. You have to hear about Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Lord. Hearing, you can become mukta. Just like Maharaj Parikshit. He simply listened about Krishna. Srimad Bhagavatam, at the last stage of his life, he listened from Sukadeva Goswami. Simply Srimad Bhagavatam, I became liberated. Sri Vishnu Savane Parikshit. The Sri Vishnu Savane about Lord Krishna, Lord Vishnu. Parikshit Maharaj became liberated. Abhavat Vyasaki Kirtane. And Vyasaki, the son of Vyasadeva, Sukadeva Goswami, He simply narrated the topics of Srimad Bhagavatam. He became liberated. There are 9 items of Bhakti Yoga. Savanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Padasivanam Archanam Bandhanam Dasam Sakham Atmanir. So if you can execute all the items, that is very good. If not, some of them, at least one. This chance is being given by the Krishna Consciousness Movement. We invite people all over the world, please come and join with this chanting, Hare Krishna. Actually, whatever development has been made, it is only by this process. We don't impose any regulation in the beginning, no. Please come and sit down and hear about Krishna. Sarvanam. If you simply continue, if you do not do anything, I guarantee that if you simply come here and hear about Krishna, you will be liberated. If you do not do anything, if you kindly come here and hear about Krishna, here or anywhere, Savanam. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu recommended this process. Sthane sthita sutigatam tanubhang manobhi je prayasa ajita jitapasi tais philakyam. This is Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's recommendation. The sthane sthita sutigatam tanubhang manobhi. You remain in your position. It doesn't require to change. Because you are grihastha or you are engineer, you are doctor or you are washerman, it doesn't matter. You remain in your position, sthane sthita. But lend your eyes for oral reception of Krishna's message. Sthane sthita sruti gata. Sruti means this ear. Allow this much the message of Krishna to enter your ears. That will help you. Sthanesthita. Sthanesthita sutigatam. Then, if you are, any man is conscious, deliver it. Then if you try to implement in practice, in your life, sthanesthita, first of all hearing, unless you hear, just like Krishna is speaking personally, you have to hear, gata-saṅgasya muktasya, jñānāvasthita caitasya, jagyāsarata karma, samagram prabhiliya. So, in this way, hearing, you become jñānāvasthita caitasya. You don't require to go to the college and school. This is also, it's simply here, even in college and school, there is percentage of attendance, hearing. All of you know that unless one has attended class of the professor, 75% is not allowed for the examination. The hearing is so important. And that is also in the case of spiritual. Hear from whom? Hear from whom? That tad-vijñānārthaṁ sa guru-meva vigacchet. Hear from Guru. Who is Guru? Guru. Then Brahmanishtham. Brahmanishtham. Guru means who knows God and fully engaged in His service. That is Guru. Tad-vijñānārthaṁ sa guru-meva vigacchet. Samitpani Shrutriyam Brahmanishtham. Shrutriyam Brahmanishtham. He has also heard from his Guru. This is both hearing. Therefore, Vedas are known as Shruti. Formerly, it was learned simply by hearing. There is no books. And there was no need of noting down. The merit was so perfect. Simply by hearing from Guru, he would understand everything. But in the Kali Yuga, because gradually, we are losing the potency of our brain. Therefore, we require in writing books. Vyasa was very kind. He knew that in the Kali Yuga, there will be no sharpened brain. Manna samanna matayo manna bhaga adhipadrita. They are made by nature, by the influence of qualities, they are all manna, very slow or very bad. Manna. Sumanna matayo, and they have got manufactured some ideas. Sumanna matayo, which is not standard to the Vedic ideas. Manna bhagya, and unfortunate. Krishna is canvassing. Here is God, here I am God. They are so unfortunate, they cannot accept. Manna bhagya. Krishna is accepted the Supreme Personality of Godhead by all the shastras. Vyasadeva, he writes, Krishna stu Bhagavan Sam. The Brahma Sangata, Brahma writes, Ishara Parama Krishna. Krishna personally says, Matta Paradaram Nanya. Arjuna, who had Bhagavad Gita, he accepts, Parabrahma Paramadhama, Pavittam Paramam Bhavam. The Acharyas, Sankaracharya, Madhyacharya, Rama, they accept Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then what evidence want you more? What is your knowledge? You do not accept so many authorities? You are so proud? That is our misfortune. Mandabhagya, Jupadrita, and disturbed condition of life. That is our misfortune. This is the position. Otherwise, where is the difficulty of understanding God? God is dead, there is no God, I am God, you are God. So many theories. Why? Here is God. God personally comes to show you what is the position of God. And He has shown what is the meaning of God. What is the meaning of Bhagavan? He has shown. Still we are so unfortunate, we cannot accept. Because we are not free from the contamination. Jisam, one can understand, Jisam antagatam papam jananam punna karmanam. Otherwise, manushanam sahasyesu jatu, kaschid jatu tisiddhaya. Jatatam kisiddhyanam kaschid vetimam tattat. So, the best thing is, that you should be submissive. You should not be proud. That will not help us. Sthane sthita sthitikatam. Jnane prayasam udapas. This so-called speculative knowledge should be given up. Jnane prayasam. Namanta eva. Just be submissive. Namanta eva. Sthitikatam tanubhangam. Jnane prayasam udapas namanta eva. Salamukharitana bhavudiya vartam. Salamukharitana. Those who are perfectly sent. Just like Vyasadeva, Ramanucharya, Madhyacharya, Salamukharitana. If they have accepted Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Salamukharitana bhavudiya vartam. In this way we can understand. We can take the lesson. Everything is clear. Now this formula that Gata-sangha sa muktas. So Gata-sangha how? Gata-sangha. To be free from the contamination of the material nature. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Mārcabhyāvi-cāyami-bhakti-yogena-jāsiva. Anyone who is engaged according to the principles, rules and regulations in bhakti-yoga, that these boys are being trained up all over the world, to rise early in the morning, to perform Mangalarti, to chant the holy name, to read Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, then take some prasadam, then go to preach, distribute books. When you go to distribute books, we are doing this very organizedly all over the world and it has become very successful. Very successful. So why not in India? Why you are neglecting this process? Where you are manufacturing something nonsense, that will not help you. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.